Good morning, students. So we have completed our first grammar topic, that is nouns. And today we are going to continue with our second topic, that is pronouns. Okay. Pronouns. So as you all know, pronoun is a word that is used in the place of a noun. Pronoun is a word that is used instead of a noun. Like, for example, Tina arrived late. Tina had a headache. Okay, so in this example, as you can see, Tina here is a proper noun because it is the name of a particular person. We have studied about it, right? And in the second sentence, it is written that Tina arrived late. She had a headache. In second sentence, in spite of Tina, I have written she. So we are replacing Tina, that is a noun, by using a word that is she. So here she is a word that is replacing the noun Tina. So she is pronoun. Okay, as you can see, first sentence is Tina arrived late, Tina had a headache, and in second sentence I have written Tina arrived late, she had a headache. In place of Tina I have written she. Okay, so pronoun is a word that is used in place of a noun. Okay, now question arises, why do we need pronouns? Why do we need them? First, we need them to avoid repetition. As you can see in previous example, here the word Tina is repeated twice. But if I am using she in place of Tina, then there is no repetition. So in order to avoid repetition, we use pronoun. Okay, sometimes noun takes up too much space, so in order to make a sentence easy, we use pronoun. For example, if I say my name is Hina, Hina is your English teacher, Hina is teaching class 6, so I am using this word Hina again and again, so it is making confusion. But if I replace this word, like my name is Hina, I am your English teacher, I will teach you English. So here I have replaced the word Hina. So the sentence, it has become more easy. So you can clearly identify it. So in order to make the sentence easy, we use pronouns. In the first is in order to avoid repetition, and second is in order to make a sentence easy, we use the word pronoun. We use pronouns. So it is clear, pronoun is a word that is used in place of a noun. And we need them to avoid repetition and to make the sentence easy. Okay. Now, next topic is types of noun. There are basically 8 types of noun. Personal pronoun, possessive pronoun, interrogative pronouns, relative pronouns, emphatic pronouns, reflexive pronouns, demonstrative pronouns, and indefinite pronouns. These are the 8 types of pronouns. So let us study about them one by one. So first is personal pronoun. Now, as the name suggests, personal, it means it is related to person. So personal pronouns are used instead of noun for person or things. Okay, we use personal pronouns in place of persons or things. For example, I, we, you, he, she, it, they. Okay, so anything that is used in place or persons or things comes under the category of personal pronoun. Now, one more thing that you need to remember here is there are 3 types of person, that is first person, second person, and third person. First person refers to the person who is speaking, like I am speaking. So I here is first person. And similarly, if there are more than one, then we are speaking. So speaker here is first person, that is I and we. Okay. Second person refers to the person who is listening, or we can say who is the listener, like you all are listening. So you are the second person. Okay, first person is speaker, that is I and we. Second person is listener, that is you. third person is non-active person, or we can say the person that we are talking about, like he, she, it, they. Okay, like for example, it is a tall building. Now here we are talking about a building. Okay, so building is not present here, so we are using the word it. It falls, it is non-active person, so it falls under the category of third person. For example, if I say I am your English teacher, now here who is the speaker? I am referring to myself. I am the speaker, so I is the first person. Another example, if I say you are a great dancer, now here I am talking about you. You are the listener, so you is the second person. Okay, so personal pronouns are used in, for persons or thing. For example, I, we, you, he, she, it, they. Okay, first person is I and we, second person is you, and third person is he, she, it, they. This is personal pronoun. Second one is possessive pronouns. Now, as we have studied possessive nouns shows relationship or ownership or possession of something. Similarly, possessive pronouns also shows possession. Okay, there are certain personal pronouns that changes into possessive pronouns, like I, me, my. It changes into mine. For example, if I say this is my book, so here I say this book is mine, so book belongs to me, it is my, it is under my possession. Okay, you become yours, he become his, she become hers. In it there is no change, it will remain it only. We will change into ours, and they will change into theirs. Okay, I changes into mine, I, me, my changes into mine, you changes into yours, he changes into his, she changes into hers, it changes in, it will remain same, we changes into ours, and they will turn into theirs. For example, if I say this is my book, and if I have to use possessive pronoun, then I will say this book is mine. Okay, it belongs to me, it is showing possession. So first was personal pronoun, that is used in place of person or thing. Second is possessive pronoun, that shows possession. Okay, third one is interrogative pronouns. Now, as you all know, interrogative pronouns are used to ask questions. Okay, any sentence that asks question falls under the category of interrogative pronouns. They mostly start with WH word, like what, where, which, how, and they always end up with a question mark. Okay, so this mostly starts with WH word and they always ends with a question mark. Like for example, who is your favorite singer? Now here I am asking a question. It is starting with WH word and at the end we are having question mark. Similarly, what is your name? Again, I am asking a question. It is starting with WH word and there in the end we are having question mark. Now, how are you? Okay, this is also a question, but it is not starting with WH, but it is ending with question mark. So as I have told you, they mostly start with WH word and they always ends up with a question mark. Okay, so for today we are going to do only these three types of pronoun. First is personal pronoun. Personal pronouns, first of all, pronouns are the word that are used in place of a noun. Okay, first is personal pronoun. Personal pronouns are the words that are used for persons or thing. For example, I, we, you, he, she, it, they. First person we have I and we, second person you, and third person he, she, it, they. Okay, first person refers to the speaker, second person refers to the listener, and third person is non-active person or the one we are talking about. Then second is possessive pronouns. This shows possession. I, me, my changes into mine, you into yours, he into his, she into hers, it will remain same, we into ours, and they into theirs. Next is interrogative pronoun. They ask question, they mostly start with WH word and they always ends with a question mark. Okay, now this is your homework. As you can see, there is help box there are some words given and all the questions, they are ending with a question mark. So it is clear that they all are interrogative pronouns. So you have to fill accordingly. You have to fill in the blanks accordingly. Okay. Thank you.